Hi, I'm Jason Roth, and this is the second video in the Learning SQL Server video series. In the previous video, we started with the basic question of, what is a database, and do I need one? In this video, I'll show you how to install the free version of Microsoft's database engine, SQL Server 2008 R2 Express. SQL Server Express is a fully functioning database engine that you can use both for learning and for real-world application development. Other paid editions of SQL Server 2008 offer additional features and services, and you can upgrade easily when necessary. To get SQL Server Express, just use your favorite search engine and look for SQL Server 2008 Express. Or you can go directly to http://www.microsoft.com/express/database. On the right, you can see installation links. Before we do this, let's quickly look at the other installation options. Note that in addition to the specific setup downloads, you can also use the Microsoft Web Platform Installer. It conveniently allows you to queue multiple installations for different tools and services. In this video, I want to go through the more manual process, but the Web Platform Installer tool is definitely a useful utility. Among the installation options, you're typically going to want to install the management tools. We don't need advanced services for now, so let's just use the Database with Management Tools option. The System Control Panel application shows that I have a 64-bit operating system, so I'm going to select the 64-bit setup program. Select your language and then click Download Now. You'll need to allow the download manager and select a location for the setup file. I'm going to place it on my desktop. When the download completes, start it. Note that you may be prompted to install the .NET framework and an updated Windows installer. Click OK. If nothing happens for a few minutes, just be patient. Eventually, the setup dialog should appear. I'd encourage you to later look at the wealth of information and tools provided by the SQL Server setup. But for our purposes, let's go straight into a new installation of SQL Server. If SQL Server R2 doesn't exist on the machine, a license terms dialog will appear. However, if SQL Server 2008 R2 already exists on your machine, you'll be asked whether you want to install a new instance or add features to the existing instance. If you see SQL Express in the list of installed instances with a version of 10.50, you already have SQL Server 2008 R2 installed. If you later learn that you're missing any features, you can add features to the existing SQL Express instance here. Getting back to our clean installation, the next step installs the setup support rules. These rules look for potential problems before you install SQL Server. If you see any errors here, you have to address those before continuing. I don't have any errors, but I do see one warning about the Windows firewall. If you click the link, you get more information. This warning tells me that the proper ports may not be open for remote access, and it provides a link for more information. This particular warning is common, and you can address it later when you need this ability. For now, we can safely continue. On this page, you will select the features you want installed with SQL Server Express. Just leave everything checked. However, there are two features I'd like to highlight here. Database Engine Services is a key feature that allows you to host SQL Server databases on this machine. And the Management Tools feature installs tools that allow you to graphically manage your database and run queries. If you're following this video and installing a different edition of SQL Server other than Express, you'll see additional options on this screen. For example, here are the installation options for the Data Center edition. The setup process between Express and other editions of SQL Server are actually very similar, but there are some differences as we see here. Getting back to our Express installation, the next step creates an instance of SQL Server. An instance manages one or more databases and is what applications connect to in order to access the data. By default, SQL Express creates a named instance called SQL Express. There is another tip here. If you had a previous version of SQL Server Express installed, the screen will look like this. You can see that SQL Express is already installed, but has a version number starting with 9.0, which is SQL Server 2005. Earlier editions of SQL Server 2008 have versions starting with 10.0 or 10.1. SQL Server 2008 R2 has versions starting with 10.50. You may be surprised to find that SQL Server Express is already installed on your machine. However, developer tools like Visual Studio automatically install SQL Server Express, and other applications could have installed Express for their use. At this point, you could quit setup and uninstall the previous version of SQL Express. But you could also just create another named instance, like SQL Express R2. This is probably safer if you're not sure. Just remember the instance name you created for later. Back to our installation, the next step asks for Windows accounts to run the SQL Server services. We're just going to accept the defaults and continue. The next step involves security. Users that access the database can use Windows Authentication, which is a Windows user or domain account, or they can use SQL Server Authentication, which is a username and password specific to SQL Server. For now, let's just use Windows Authentication. Note that your current logged-on user is automatically made a system administrator. We'll talk more about security in a future video. In this step, you can choose to report errors to improve future versions of SQL Server. After several minutes, SQL Server 2008 R2 Express should be successfully installed. Let's do a quick test to make sure everything worked. On the Start menu, click All Programs, Microsoft SQL Server 2008 R2, and then Start SQL Server Management Studio. At the connection dialog, type /SQL Express, and then click Connect. A clean connection means that we're ready to start creating, managing, and using databases. Setup is never a fun task, but hopefully this video has helped you to successfully install SQL Server 2008 R2 Express. For additional resources, go to http://learningsqlserver.wordpress.com. In future Learning SQL Server videos, we'll actually start working with databases, which, of course, is the goal. Thanks for watching.